Good morning, YouTube. Welcome back to my channel. It is bright and early here in the greenhouse, and I thought I would give a Highland greenhouse tour consisting of a lot of Nepenthes and some cool growing orchids and other cool growing carnivorous plants and stuff like that. So why don't we get started on this guy? It's going to be a fairly big tour, so let's just kind of do what we always do and start and go clockwise sort of thing. A lot of things are hanging up. Draculas are loving this time of year. Look at all these spikes on this. This is a Dracula Bella. Here's another Bella. Not so many spikes, but bigger flowers on it. Dracula Mopsis. And a few other Nepenthes are hanging up there as well. Sorry about the backlighting. We're still very bubble wrapped for winter time. We have had the worst winter here. It has been 6 weeks of 10 degrees Celsius below normal, so that kind of sucks. Look at this, this is a first time bloomer for me. This is one of my Equigenera plants, I'm just grabbing the tag here. There's the tag for it. And yeah, it's not supposed to smell very nice apparently, but honestly it has no smell whatsoever. Big Masdevallia though. So I was happy to see that. What else is going on up here? A few yellowing leaves are coming off just because it's winter time. And yeah, this is my Ventricosa. It's one of my first Nepenthes I ever got. It sits on the floor now in sort of a moss tray down there. And my Glabrata is down here as well. These guys get no light this time of year, but still some nice pictures on the Glabrata. This is a basil shoot, so that's nice. The vine's probably 6-7 feet tall now. A few little pictures down there. Basil's coming out on the Ventrata as well. We're not gonna go into the other side here beyond this bubble wrap screen. This is a few layers of plastic with bubble wrap. Totally different world in there, it's like so warm. But yeah, we'll get to the temperature in here as we pass it by. This wall, what's going on with this wall? Hoyas are kind of drooping down from the ceiling up there, from the roof up behind the orchid. My big fern, I don't know, takes up so much room. Little Masdevallia here, that's cute. That's another Equigenera one. A few bromeliads. Some more bromeliads, those are carnivorous bromeliads. Some air plants. All sort of stuck in here. Here's some blooms on this one, this is gonna be bright. I'm gonna turn off this light if I can. Bear with me, I'm just like reaching off screen here looking for a switch. Maybe that'll be better. Yeah, that's gonna be much better. All the lights are on, hopefully that doesn't ruin the video, but that's about as good as these flowers get. They're little white flowers, so that's cool. There's another one there. What else do we have going on in here today? Some more orchids up high. Some more Hoyas up high. They're still growing, albeit slow. There's no blooms this time of year. But I bet you, with spring just around the corner, they're going to burst out into bloom. I did some cuttings just the other day, and I'm just trying to do some water culture cuttings, see if they root in water. Now, the light I turned off was actually for this. I wanted to make sure I showed it today, because I always seem to miss it. That is my Ultra Highland Chamber. This gets nighttime lows colder than the regular greenhouse. The lows go down to about 47 Fahrenheit, or about 8 Celsius, I guess. This is mainly for my Nepenthes villosas and some other cool growing orchids in there. I even took one villosa out, which you'll probably see later as a reminder, so we'll pass by that villosa, and that was supposed to jog my memory in case you didn't get here. These guys are doing exceptionally well, for villosas anyways. So you can see how big, that's a seed grown one. This one's from AW here. Some little ones that will be available in the spring. I have been sitting on these guys for at least 6 months now, making sure they're establishing nicely, and they're starting to put on new growth. I've got at least two new leaves on every one of those plants. I'm doing a little experiment with my Temminiis, growing some really cold and some just regular cold. Yeah, this is a nice pod of three. Look at that leaf jump on that one. So, doing very well in here, and this is controlled with the Zoomed Hygrotherm. Now we're going to go back up here. These are some other plants that I will have available. So I'm not going to go through all these guys, but if you're in Canada, they are available. This guy is awesome. I only have a couple. This is a Petalodocross vicii. I pulled this out the other day just to photograph this picture because it's amazing. So that's going to be a nice plant for somebody. Moving a little bit further, my Odontocidiums, I think they're called, are in bloom. They're actually starting to fade a little bit, but they bloom in the dead of winter. This is Masdevallia exquisita, and here's a little Scaphocephalum as well. What else do we have here? Down below are Dracula orchids that aren't in bloom. And so because they don't have spikes coming out the bottom, I'm not bothering to hang them up. So they just kind of stay there under lights. These trays slide in and out a little bit. Put them back under the lights here. Little Masdevallia Siberian garden gnome. There's the tag for the white onto glossums there, Pachellum. These are some Cephalotus. And ooh, this is kind of cool. Check this out. I germinated some Disa orchids. So these are going to be Uniflora. Well, they're not going to be. They are Uniflora. And this is my new little Eden Black. And it's doing okay, actually. It's made a good recovery from its traveling. And my Hummer's Giant. Again, these are two new ones for me, so they're not too impressive. I sowed some of my own seeds late last year. Just some of the scraps that were kind of left over. So they've stratified, and I pulled them out of stratification in the end of November. So I'm expecting to see something from them soon, but I don't see anything yet, at least not through camera. Some Cephalotus divisions, some Heliamphora divisions, a bunch more Hoyas, not quite in bloom, right along the front here, just sort of vining down. What else? Here's some of my bigger Heliamphoras. A lot of Heterodoxa right here. Saracenoides. And a couple others back there as well. So they're doing quite well. They've all been repotted this year, or last year, I guess. So they're just sort of now recovering, getting back on their feet. A few of my little tiny seedlings. So we won't again get into the different kinds here, but they're doing quite well. Here's where my larger Hamadas are. And they're doing really well for the winter. This one has now got two basal shoots that I can see. That one's still got none that I can see in there. I'm really zoomed in right now. And then back behind this one, you can see a nice few leaves from a basil pitcher there. So I'm excited about those new growths, because when the new growth comes out the bottom here, it's actually usually more robust than the main vine itself. It kind of grows with more vigor. So I would expect those to actually catch up with the main vine in growth in just a year or two. So happy about that. Some of my Cephalotus here. They are recovering from last year's long, hot summer. And I had them on the warm side of the greenhouse for the summertime last year. And I don't think I'm going to do that again. By the end of summer last year, they were really, really tired. Now they bloomed, they seeded, they did all their things that they need to do. But when I brought them back to the cool side, they were definitely ready for some dormancy, some cool weather. And so they've all sort of recovered from that and are growing nicely again. And oops, my mic is caught. And yeah, they're looking quite nice. Different colors. Here is a couple pots of German Giant. Again, they're small because I got them last summer, but happy with them and they're doing quite well. Let's go back down here. You'll notice all the mosses are doing really well in here. It took me a few years to figure out how to grow moss. It's actually harder to grow than the plants that it's potted in. I lost a lot of moss. I killed a lot of moss. So hopefully this summer I'm going to try a few different things and maybe we can keep it alive for the summertime too. But yeah, these are my Helium 4s here, so it's hard to see what everything is from this angle. And that's a parva. That's my hairy parva actually. So it's doing quite well. You can see how hairy it is. Some miners, some regular parvas there. Now I do find the lights make the old pictures kind of go blotchy, and then the new growth is kind of accustomed to the light, so it's definitely not hard to get bright red growth under lights, though. It's so easy. And these are just cheap shop lights. Lots of miners back there. Another nice parva there. Expendiculata. Puchella. And yeah, it's gonna be tough to see them all. This is my burgundy black. So that's a new picture. Oh, I can see another new picture coming through the moss there as well. So the moss is just crazy. I think I need to do a video on growing moss. I did do a video on like starting to cultivate moss, what you do when you have like a little bit, but now I need to do a video on what you do when you have a lot of moss. Moving over here to more Nepenthes. Petiolota. Deanias down there. This is a Sibuensis. It's just open, so it hasn't colored up yet. This is a Ventricosa hamata. Tendrils are caught on the mic cord. My Lamiae are down here. You can see I have them hanging on a funny angle. That's for drainage. It means all the water comes to like one point down here on all of these. So you'll sort of see a trend here if I am. There's a Lamiae, another Lamiae, Argentii, and Monticola. So all of them I'm trying to give exceptional drainage to, which is why they're on their sides like that. Not a lot is happening down with the orchids down there. I do see my Pleurothallids Dragonstonii is in bloom way down at the back there. Some more Sibuensis. I need to do some trimming of some dead leaves around here, which will come. I found I'm just starting to get into my spring cleaning again now, doing some repotting. Masdevallia Vinrouge. Had a slug attack at some point of this winter. I just actually pulled it out. It wasn't sitting there. Oops, and let's get you back in focus. Focus. There we go. Now this sort of area here, this is kind of what I was hoping my entire greenhouse would look like at one point. But due to how many plants I'm acquiring, I don't have space for moss like this everywhere. But where I do have space for it, I do like it. So this is a Renwortiana. It's supposed to be Highland, but it's growing super slow this time of year. I'm tempted to move it over to the lowland side, and I'm sure it's going to just explode on the lowland side. Oh, we forgot to look at the temperature in here. Spectabilis. Spectabilis is pretty crazy. It's above our head as well. Lots of Sorry about the backlighting. Lots of pictures on it. Some seed pods. Well, we're up here, we might as well be looking at some other stuff going on up here. This Dracula orchid has just finished blooming. Here's some nice Dracula orchids here. The backlighting makes it so horrible. I hate looking up. But anyways, lots of spikes on them. Bongso, looking good. Big pictures. But I'm just slowly working my way back to the temperature, which is where I'm going over here. So it is currently only 64 Fahrenheit in here, or 18 Celsius, and 95% humidity. Remember I said it's morning, so the nighttime low would have been close to the 55 mark. So it's warmed up about 9 degrees in here. We'll swing you back slowly around again. This is just a species from Dorman's Top, I think. Bah, man, the backlighting is killing me. I hate it. It's good when you're looking under it, but here is our stick project that we did together. Remember we did that like hanging garden stick? It's doing quite well. There was some stuff out in bloom not too long ago. Oh, there's still some stuff in bloom out here. Some masdevallias are blooming on this stick. As usual, the butterworts are blooming away in there. I repotted some in the fall, and they don't get as much attention as they deserve. They're just sort of tucked in the corner there, but whatever. All of these pictures hanging are just plain old ventrata. Going back to over here. So this is Alba. It's a nice size Alba. This is Raja here. It's becoming a nice size Raja. I'm happy with it. This is my first intermediate picture on Platychilla. It's last picture looked like this. And now it's a little bit more intermediate, so we're hoping I'm hoping this one's gonna be a good one right here. That's Platychilla there. Intermiss is here. It has no pictures on right now. I find it really finicky for me. Back behind that, there's a Lavicola. My Tentaculata is back there, and a few of my plants here, and then a few plants that I have to offer. Some of my seed-grown Niagara, getting pretty dark, getting pretty big. This guy here is Mira, one of my favorite plants. I love it. It's so Raja-like. It's actually in bloom right now as well. And just like most Nepenthes, oh, come on, whoa. Lighting is doing like weird things. Just like with most Nepenthes, this is a male. What else do we have here? This is another, I'm zooming you back out, Alba. Now, Alba pitchers are only white when they're uppers, so don't let the name confuse you. This is my Pitopangii. And it's starting to vine now. It has no pitchers on it right now. I guess because it's like the dead of winter and I'm expecting too much from it. I do pretty good with pitchers on most of my plants all year. There is an awesome Jamban pitcher and a Flava right beside it. Another nice Flava over here. Try not to spill the liquid that's in it. What else do we have? So there's moss. Look at this moss. It's just crazy. And basically, I keep it moist. I just never let it dry out. I do a lot of superficial spraying, just misting and stuff like that to keep it moist. And then do a good drenching to make sure the pots... I don't want the pots to be soaking wet all the time, but I don't want the moss tips to dry out either. That's where the challenge is going to be this summer. But the moss has just exploded. And there's a few different kinds of mosses here. Some that's nice with like red colors. And this one here is interesting. It has like orange tips to it. So that's kind of cool. Right here is a nice little seed grown Edwardsiana. This one here is a seed grown Macrophylla. I'm told it's seed grown anyways, but it's behaving more like a tissue culture. It came in nice and big. with a good soft looking root. By soft I just mean not black, it was still like almost green. And so the root needed to establish, which meant it got smaller and smaller leaves for a while, and now the leaves are finally getting bigger as the root has established 6 months later. Here is my little Velosa. That was a reminder to show you the Velosa chamber, and I just repotted that like 2 days ago. There's a bunch of little things in here. Moluensis lowii. This is a Wistuba Edwardsiana Burbigii, or reverse that. Little Hurleyana. Little Raja. Another little Raja in the middle there. And there is my Argentii. Now make sure you're not looking at the Raja picture in the foreground. The Argentii is in the back there. Happy little plant. My Sophronides, Coccinia is out in bloom. I have one flower left on it. Man, that's bright. It just pops on the camera. I do have a bunch of stuff above our heads as well, but I can't really get into all of it. McFarlaneii, Flavas. But I brought down some nice ones to show you anyways. This is Hematopodichilla. It's in bloom right now, also a boy. Yeah, there are Attenboroughii. One I recently repotted and the other one I haven't. Disa orchid out in bloom. Being it was so cold, I had to bring in all my outdoor stuff. Normally that doesn't make it in the greenhouse. But yeah, it's just been, it just let up. It's like warmer now again. Vogelii. Lowii. Kind of a bit of under the lip hairs happening. Edwardsiana. That's not my newest picture, but it's probably my nicest. This one just opened, but it's a winter picture, so it's a little smaller. Due to the fact that everything was so cold outside, I brought in my cobra lilies. And so, of course, they started blooming for me. So I just pollinated this. That's a cobra lily flower. And I see another one coming down here. These things usually actually start to spike this time of year, but it is still cold enough outside, being it's January, that I usually lose the bloom stalks. Silly things. Dactylorhizal orchid, of course, is coming up too because I didn't want it outside because it was like really cold. And like, it was a horrible winter for us. This is Rob Cantleyi Hemata. Here is a Macrophylla. Nice one inflating there. A few more little Hematas down here. When I say little, I mean they're only like 6-inch plants. A lot more moss. Just growing in everywhere, so yeah. I love the look of the moss. The plants love to picture in it. There's a nice little single Anna picture. And that one is Sibuensis Hemata. This one here, I can't get a good look at. It almost looks like the Sibuensis Hemata, but that's a Burkeii Hemata. There are some Ventricosa cream color pictures. Aristo cross Ventricosa. Here is my Rob Cantleyi. I just brought that down to show you as well. That's why it looks kind of awkward there. Down below are some Mastivalias and other plants. The Disa orchids are down there. Nice Cymbidium out in bloom. I don't know that I have the tag for this guy anymore. But I see two spikes on it. But yeah, the tag has vanished. So that kind of sucks. Some trays of moss down there. I actually cultivate the moss outside and then just bring in like a tray when I need it. and then put the old trays that I've kind of ravaged back outside to regrow, and it seems to be working quite nicely. But as I say, maybe I'll do another moss video for you guys. But yeah, I think that's basically where I'm going to leave it for now. Tenuous. Cecilia. And yeah, so that's where I'm going to leave it for now. I hope you guys liked this video. And if you want to see more videos like this, make sure you subscribe to my channel. As always, thanks for watching.